Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how to get your TeslaMate data to display in Home Assistant for using it to do home automations or other kinds of cool things. If you are familiar with TeslaMate, you probably know that it gives you a ton of data about your car, and it's really useful for some people to be able to see that in their Home Assistant. However, the instructions to do this are a little complicated, and if you're not running things a specific way, it can be a little bit confusing. So I wanted to make this video to show you all how I did it because it's a bit more advanced than your standard setup. Now, you can run TeslaMate within Home Assistant itself, and Tesla, one of the nice things about Home Assistant is that it has kind of its own built-in version of Docker. So this lets you run these additional server apps within Home Assistant itself. However, I run Unraid and that has its own Dockers, and I actually have Home Assistant set up not as a Docker in Unraid, but as a virtual machine in Unraid. And this allows me to pass through some additional hardware through my Unraid server that I want Home Assistant to use and gives me a little bit more control over my Dockers rather than running them in Home Assistant, and basically generally makes the system easier for me to manage. However, this creates some complicated things when I'm trying to make this data show up because my TeslaMate is running an Unraid Docker, not in Home Assistance. So, in order to set up TeslaMate in Unraid, there are a few different applications you need to set up. You have to set up the TeslaMate app, you have to set up the Grafana app for displaying the graphs, and you need to set up an MQTT broker. So those are kind of the three Dockers that you'll set up in Unraid, and I'm not going to cover that in this video. You can find how to do that other places, but it's pretty straightforward. However, there are a few changes you'll need to make to those Dockers in order to get this to work. So the biggest limitation to not running TeslaMate inside of Home Assistant and running a separate MQTT broker outside of Home Assistant is that you need a way to kind of make those brokers talk to each other. So I'm running a separate MQTT broker inside of Home Assistant. You could just point the MQTT broker to the one outside, but it gets kind of funky. So what we need to do is set up what's called an MQTT bridge. And I found this guide over on the Home Assistant forums that actually kind of shows you how to set up this MQTT bridge so that if you're running two instances of MQTT, they'll talk to one another. So for our purposes, and there's going to be some modifications here of some config files, I found it's actually easier to start with the Home Assistant version of MQTT and to make these changes via the SSH add-on. So if you don't know what any of that is, sorry, you're going to have to do a bunch of Googling, but it's not really that complicated. So if I'm following this guide, I was able to SSH into my Home Assistant, and you'll see here that there's a couple folders. We need to get to the share instance inside of Home Assistant. So I'm going to change directory to share. And if you're this is the first time you're setting anything up, you won't have anything in this folder. And you will need to make a folder called mosquitto. So you can make directory mosquitto. Hit enter, and I've already done that, so you'll see the directory is there. So I can change directory into mosquitto, and you'll need to create a config file here. So if you haven't done this before, you'll touch mosquitto.conf, and that'll create the file that we need. And again, I've already done this, so there it is. And then we'll need to go into this file and edit it. And I prefer to use nano, and in this SSH client, nano actually works pretty well. If you're trying to do this in Unraid through the console for Docker, you'll notice that there is no kind of nano in there, so it's a little bit more difficult to edit the files. But I'll show you how to do that in a second. So for this, we're going to nano mosquitto.conf. And it's just a copy and paste of this code, and you'll paste it into your file. I've already done that. And the only changes you'll need to make here are to the address. So point this to your existing TeslaMate URL. In my case, it's just an IP address and a port. And then you'll also want to come down here and change the user. So in my Home Assistant MQTT broker, I'm actually using a Home Assistant user, And that's one of the nice things about using that add-on is that it can use Home Assistant native users. So I just made one called MQTT user, password MQTT user. And with that added to this file, we're done. We can Control X and save it to the file. So that completed the first step of this guide. If you come down here to the second part, now it says we need to go over to Unraid and make some changes. And if you've set up TeslaMate in the past or a long time ago on Unraid, the mosquitto configuration there, I believe it originally used to be anonymous. You could have the option to run an insecure MQTT server. I think they've changed this in subsequent versions of mosquitto. And now the default is that you need a username and password. But you'll want to come into your template and check that this setting here is set to zero. And that will make it so that it's no longer running as an insecure server. You'll also want to come into your TeslaMate template and add that username and password for MQTT just so that it is all in sync. And if you need to create those additional files, you can open up the console window for mosquitto and it'll look like this. And where we need to go to is first, let's see what's in here. Okay, we have a few folders. So we need to change directory to mosquitto. And we need to change into the config directory. And again, this is going to match whatever you set up here in the template. So if your config file should be appdata mosquitto, that'll make things pretty easy. And in here, we need to create two files, the access control list file and the password file, and that's straight from, again, these instructions. So we can touch password, and we can touch access control list. And in order to make sure that this is secure, we'll need to run another command which makes the password file more secure. And when you touch password, it'll tell you that you need to run it may display a message saying you need to change the folder permissions to make it secure. So Unraid will just display that message, just do what it says. You may have to run another command to kind of hash this password file. But that's pretty much it. So you'll paste in the things that it says here. Again, make sure your user in the access control list file is MQTT user or whatever you're using for your username. So let me just show you what this looks like. After you've created the files here, your app data folder, and you'll see those files listed. So my access control, I have the MQTT user, and I'm good to go. So that's everything you really need to do in Unraid. You can come back over here to the MQTT add-on in Home Assistant, make sure it's running, make sure its configuration is active true. And if you check the logs, you'll see that you have the connection coming from your Unraid server if everything is running correctly. You may get this error if you're having, you know, if you don't have that access control list set up in there, you may see some errors that'll tell you you did something wrong. So with that, if you'll see your IP address of your Unraid server, that means the bridge is working correctly and you can move on to the next step, which is configuring all of the sensors in Home Assistant. So to do that, the file editor is probably the easiest way to do that. And the first thing you're going to need to do is to modify your configuration.yaml. So this is the TeslaMate documentation now, and it's pretty much follows the guide as written. So you copy this first section, you'll go back to your file editor, and if you've never messed around with this at all before, you want to find your configuration.yaml file. You can paste this in at the bottom of it. You may have some other configs if you've ever done anything else in Home Assistant, but you'll paste this in. The only changes I needed to make were that the documentation here has an automation file referenced already. My file had a different one called automations. I think it may just be an artifact of some things I've done before. But if your file is automations or automation, you just make sure you only have it in here once and it matches whatever the file is. The other change I made was I commented out this Tesla section. I think this is if you want to be able to control your actual car's abilities. You probably need to put in your Tesla username and password. I just want to read the data from TeslaMate, so I didn't think this was needed, so I commented it out. Obviously, check up here to see if you have any errors in your config file when you're saving it. If you do, it'll have a red X and tell you what it is. Mine checked out, so I got the green check here, and I can close and save this file. So that was the first YAML edit. Next, we want to create this MQTT sensors.yaml and copy everything here in this section. So I created that folder here. You can go up here to the top, new file, MQTT sensors, paste this information in, and the changes you need to make in this file are to specify the path for your, again, your TeslaMate instance. If it's outside of Home Assistant, it'll have a different IP. You can change your model. So the default is a 3, mine's a Y. So I changed these two lines and I saved that and that was good to go. Next file is gonna be called sensor.yaml. So same as the last thing, we go up here, new file, sensor.yaml. And this is just a paste. You don't need to make any changes to this. You can just save it and move to the next one. So this last one is binary-sensor.yaml. So again, new file, binary-sensor, paste the data in there. No changes are needed to this either. You can just save it and you're done. There is a Lovelace card in here. I'm not gonna cover that in this, but if you wanna use these Lovelace cards that are specified in the Home Assistant integration, to get this nice layout, you can set that up elsewhere as well. But once you do all these files, you can restart your Home Assistant. And if you check back in your MQTT add-on, you should see the new entries now for your Tesla. So that'll give you all of these sensors. I hope that helps. I know the documentation can be a little confusing and there's some various different setups out there with folks running Docker in different places. So I hope this helps if you were kind of getting stumped with how to set this up. Thanks.